Thank you. Unstoppable. John Cobb's Railton takes the record past another milestone speed. The very next day, George Easton was out on the flats with 357.5 miles per hour. Cobb replied a year later with an electrifying 367.9 miles per hour. War in Europe eclipsed all further thoughts of land speed records until 1947. John Cobb dusts off his Railton to return to Bonneville, raising his own record with a one-way run of over 400 miles per hour. August 1960, and a bizarre and diverse lineup of machines takes place at Bonneville.
Country garage serving the local community, not just the A garage like this traces its origins back to the days of the blacksmith Fulbright. Some were involved in carriage building. An agricultural engineer easily adapted their trade to handle this new form of transport, the motorbike. Over 100 years ago, they were owned by local dignitaries who survived and maintained them. Petrol was sold by the man. A chauffeur was trained to look after the car, but as more and more people became owner-drivers, the need for the garage or motorworks increased. Tire was common test, car owners know their tires to wear through before replacing them. The early engines required rebuilding regularly, Around every 500 valves had to be ground in and cylinders decarbonized. Available off the shelf. And many had to be handmade in the garage. Cars came from many different manufacturers and in many different countries. Sometimes existing goods would have to adapt to suit a particularly difficult job. The great Victorian cycling era. Some garages grew out of the bicycle or small-time cycle manufacturer. Here, a part of the workshop is reserved for cycles. Hanging from the rafters above you are examples from earlier years, now brought out only on special occasions. Like this garage, most homes did not have mains electricity. However, they did have battery-powered radios and even into the garage for recharging. Some garages were able to repair radios, as well as lawnmowers and machinery. But more often than not, they were found putting a patch on a kettle or salt. Garage owners turned to a lot of hire car available for porting, but not hire.
Thank you.
You're standing in a typical Sanctuary Drive crowd. A country guy shows the local scenery in not just the local space. A garage like this is a place of its origin back to the days of Saturday. When carves first appeared over 100 years ago, they were owned by local dignitaries who employed chauffeurs to drive and maintain them. Several were sold by the hardware shop and the local blacksmith, who also, on occasions, helped the chauffeur with repairs.